Polysophonia shows an isomorphic triphasic alternation of generations. Both gametophytic and sporophytic generations are identical. Sexual reproduction takes place in the gametophytic plants and asexual reproduction occurs in the sporophytic plants. In the life cycle of polysophonia, three kinds of thalli are found. These are haploid gametophyte, diploid carposporophyte, and diploid tetrasporophyte. The gametophytic thalli are haploid, free-living, and dioecious, that is, heterothallic. Male and female sex organs are born on different plants. The male sex organs, called spermatangia, are produced on male gametophytic plants, while the afemale sex organs, that is, carpogonia, are formed on female gametophytic plants. The carposporophyte is diploid and remains attached to the female gametophyte as a parasite. It develops from the zygote after fertilization. The carposporophyte reproduces asexually by the formation of diploid spores called carpospores. The tetrasporophytic plant is formed by the germination of diploid carpospores. It is diploid and independent. The tetrasporophyte reproduces asexually by producing haploid tetraspores. Tetrasporophytes and gametophytes both are morphologically similar but differ in producing the reproductive organs. Sexual reproduction in polysophonia is of the advanced oogamous type. It occurs in the gametophytic thalli. Most of the gametophytic thalli are heterothallic, that is, dioecious. The sex organs are developed on different plants. The male sex organs are spermatangia, born on male plants. The female plants bear female sex organs called carpogonia or procarps. The spermatangium or antheridium is the male sex organ in polysophonia. Many spermatangia are produced in dense clusters on the fertile trichoblasts near the apex of the male gametophytic plant. Initially, the male trichoblast develops as a side branch on the plant body. Each trichoblast, when it is only 2 to 3 celled, divides dichotomously and becomes branched. In most of the species, one branch remains sterile and the other bears spermatangia. In some species, both branches become fertile. The sterile branch may divide again to form fertile trichoblasts. The spermatangia-bearing fertile trichoblasts are called spermatangial branches. During the development of the spermatangium, all cells of the uniaxial trichoblast except a few basal cells, that is 2 to 3 cells, divide periclinally and form pericentral cells on both sides. The pericentral cells may divide once or twice to form spermatangial mother cells on the outer side. Each spermatangial mother cell cuts off 2 to 4 spermatangia or antheridia. The complete structure forms a cone-shaped cluster of spermatangia. The mature spermatangium is a short-stalked, spherical, or oblong unicellular structure. The cell wall of each spermatangium is differentiated into 3 layers: the inner reflective, the middle gelatinous, and the outer thick layer. The contents of the spermatangium metamorphose into a single, non-motile, male gamete, or spermatium. Each spermatium is liberated from the spermatangium by the formation of a narrow apical slit in the spermatangial wall. The liberated spermatia are dispersed by water currents. After the liberation of spermatia, new spermatangia may develop on the old spermatangia. The carpogonium, that is the oogonium, is the female sex organ in polysophonia. It develops on a greatly reduced fertile trichoblast of the female gametophytic plant. During the development of the carpogonium, the female trichoblast initial arises from the central siphon, 2 to 4 cells below the apical cell. It divides repeatedly to form a reduced female trichoblast of 5 to 7 cells. The 3 lowermost cells of the female trichoblast divide vertically and form an ensheathing layer of pericentral cells, which are arranged in 3 tiers, one above the other. One of the pericentral cells in the middle tier, on the adaxial side, that facing the main axis, becomes the supporting cell. The supporting cell cuts off a small initial cell at its free end, that is, outside part, called the procarp initial. The procarp initial cell undergoes repeated divisions to form a small, curved, four-celled branch known as the carpagonial filament or procarp. The terminal cell of the carpagonial filament functions as the carpagonial mother cell. The carpagonial mother cell further develops into the flask-shaped carpagonium. The carpagonium consists of a basal swollen portion, the carpagonial base, in which the egg or female gamete is present, and an upper elongated, tubular portion called the trichogyne. Simultaneously, the supporting cell cuts off two sterile cells, one at the base, called the basal sterile filament initial, and another at the lateral side, the lateral sterile filament initial. The lateral sterile filament initial divides transversely to forms a two-celled lateral sterile filament. The pericentral cells adjacent to the supporting cell start growing to cover the carpagonium, that is, fertilized carpagonium. Later on, they form a sterile sheath, or the protective covering, around the carpagonium called the pericarp. The pericarp develops an opening at the tip, which is known as the osteole. During fertilization, the spermatia are carried by the water currents to the carpagonium. As the spermatia reach the carpagonium, one of them adheres to the trichogyne. The walls between the trichogyne and the spermatium dissolve at the point of contact. The male nucleus enters the trichogyne and moves down to the swollen base of the carpagonium. Finally, the male nucleus fuses with the egg nucleus and forms the diploid zygote. After fertilization, many changes occur simultaneously within and around the carpagonium of Polysiphonia. These changes lead to the development of the cysticarp. Immediately after fertilization, the two-celled lateral sterile filament divides and becomes a short filament of 4 to 10 cells. The basal sterile initial divides to form a two-celled basal sterile filament. Simultaneously, the supporting cell of the carpagonium divides transversely and develops a haploid auxiliary cell on its upper side, just below the basal portion of the carpagonium. The auxiliary cell then establishes a tubular cytoplasmic connection with the carpagonial base. Now, the diploid zygotic nucleus within the carpagonium divides mitotically into two diploid daughter nuclei. One of the nuclei migrates into the auxiliary cell through the tubular connection, and the other one remains in the carpagonium. Thus, the auxiliary cell contains one haploid nucleus and one migrated diploid nucleus. The haploid nucleus in the auxiliary cell now degenerates. The trichogyne gradually begins to shrivel. The diploid nucleus present in the auxiliary cell then divides mitotically and forms two daughter nuclei. One of the nuclei migrates into a small lateral outgrowth developed on the upper side of the auxiliary cell. This small outgrowth on the auxiliary cell is called the gonomoblast initial. In this way, many gonomoblast initials can develop on the auxiliary cell. Now, each gonomoblast initial divides by repeated mitotic divisions to form a short multicellular filament called the gonomoblast filament or gonimolobe. The terminal cell of the gonimoblast filament becomes swollen and develops into a pear-shaped carposporangium. The contents of the carposporangium metamorphoses into a single non-motile diploid carpospore. Meanwhile, the carpagonium, auxiliary cell, and supporting cell fuse together and form a single large, irregularly shaped nutritive cell called the placental cell or central cell. The placental cell provides nourishment to the growing carposporophyte, that is, carposporangia and carpospores. The pericentral cells of the female trichoblast, adjacent to the supporting cell, produce a number of vegetative filaments. Many gonimoblast filaments attached to the placental cell are covered by sterile vegetative filaments and develop an urn-shaped structure called the cysticarp. The outer covering of the cysticarp is a two-layered wall and is known as the pericarp. The pericarp is haploid and has an opening at the apex called the osteole. The diploid part of the cysticarp represents the carposporophyte, that is, the carposporangia-bearing carpospores. Thus, the cystocarp is a partly haploid and partly diploid structure. Asexual reproduction in polysiphonia takes place in the sporophytic plants. It occurs through the formation of carpospores and tetraspores. Carpospores develop in the carposporophyte, while tetraspores produce in the tetrasporophyte. The carpospore is diploid, non-motile, uninucleate, and developed in the carposporophyte. The mature carposipers are liberated from the cystocarp through the ostiole and are carried away by water currents. On coming into contact with the suitable substratum, the carpospore secretes a wall around it and attaches itself to the substratum. It then divides by mitotic division to form a small lower cell and a large upper cell. Both of these cells again divide mitotically and form a four-celled small filament. The lowermost cell of the filament is called the rhizoidal cell. The rhizoidal cell elongates and forms the colorless rhizoids. The uppermost cell is dome-shaped and functions as the apical cell. The apical cell divides by transverse division and forms the central siphon cell. The central cell undergoes further division, that is, periclinal division, to form pericentral cells and ultimately develop the polysiphonous body. In this way, the carpospore germinates into the diploid tetrasporophytic plant. The tetrasporophyte is a free-living, diploid plant. It is morphologically similar to the gametophytic plants, but does not bear sex organs. The tetrasporophyte reproduces asexually by means of tetraspores. The tetraspores develop in the tetrasporangium of the tetrasporophyte. The tetrasporangium is a sac-like diploid structure. It is produced from the pericentral cell of the thallus near the apical region. The single pericentral cell of each tier toward the apical region functions as the tetrasporangial initial. This pericentral cell, that is, the tetrasporangial initial, is smaller than the other pericentral cells in the same tier. The tetrasporangial initial divides vertically and forms an outer cell and an inner cell. The outer cell further divides to form two or more cover cells. The inner cell functions as the sporangial mother cell. The sporangial mother cell then divides transversely into a lower stalk cell and an upper tetrasporangial cell. The tetrasporangial cell enlarges and develops into the tetrasporangium. The fertile branches bearing tetrasporangia become twisted and swollen. The diploid nucleus of the tetrasporangium undergoes meiosis, forming four haploid tetraspores or meiospores. The spores are arranged tetrahedrally in the tetrasporangium. At maturity, the tetraspores are liberated by rupturing of the sporangial wall, along with lifting of the two cover cells. The liberated tetraspores germinate into new haploid gametophytic plants. Due to the heterothallic nature of polysiphonia, two of the four tetraspores develop male plants and the other two produce female plants.